We are good. Let's sit down and talk about some of the lessons, the top lessons I've learned in the past 5 years working as a software developer. I'm not gonna lie, I didn't even know if I was gonna share this, but right before I sat down, I just finished work for the day, and a lot of my day today, not a lot, but part of it was definitely, there were tears. It was a tough day. Something that I didn't expect to have 5 years in, but here I am 5 years in, and there are days that you feel like you know nothing. That doesn't go away. Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. Before we get into it, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding content. And as always, I try and be as real and candid as possible, because if you are in tech and just wanting to grow your career, or maybe you want to break in tech, we need transparency. We need to be honest and real with each other. And that's what this conversation is about today. I'm just sitting down to chat with you about the top things I would say that I have learned in the past 5 years working as a software developer. Actually, let's rewind that a bit. I've been working professionally for 4.5 years, but the first six months was learning and growing. Just sounded kind of long to say 4.5 years, so we're just gonna say 5. We're jumping ahead a bit. I think one of the main things that I have learned in the past 5 years that would have kind of shocked me initially is that your work should be replaceable. Meaning the work that you are capable of doing, if you were to vanish tomorrow, it should be written, your code should be written in such a good way, and your mentorship of what you gave other people advice of have been passed down, that if you disappear tomorrow, someone else can pick up where you left off. This goes back to always trying to focus on quality code and implement quality code. I know it's one of those things that it's the balance of finding quality code versus finishing a ticket in time and having that balance, but making code that leaves your footprint, that when you leave that company, the person who replaces you can come in and be like, oh, thank goodness that the last developer who just left, they were good. The one thing though I don't think should be replaceable is your personality. The things that you bring to the team, the uniqueness you have, we're all so unique. And I think a lot of times when I first started coding, I thought coding is a technical skill. That's all it is. And yes, on paper that is true. It is just a technical skill. But to be a good coder, I truly believe after 5 years of working in the industry that you need to have soft skills as well. You can't just have the technical skills without the soft skills. Yes, you can have a career that way, but you're not going to succeed or very quickly. And it kind of takes the fun out of things. It's fun building a community and getting to work closely with your coworkers. And I know we love coworkers, but we hate coworkers, but they're strange and it's like this weird relationship. But try and have a friendship to some degree with them. It makes work a lot easier. And that brings me to my next thing, which is people around you really, really matter. If you are working on a team where you don't respect the people, your leaders or your managers, or you don't jive with them, it's going to make for a very painful experience. People around you really matter, and you really want to have that sense of community when you are working. Even if you are a fully remote developer, you can still build that sense of community by interacting with your coworkers, getting to know them, what are their interests outside of work. It also, for me, made it much easier when I had a question or was uncertain about something to go to someone who I had that rapport with, that trust with. And the only way you can build that is getting to know your coworkers. Another thing that is so important, and it's one of those things that I realized further on in my career, the more I grow, the more I realize this, is not everyone knows everything. I used to think that senior developers or technical leads, they must have all the answers, have everything figured out. Now, as a senior developer, I'm like, no, that's not the case at all. We maybe get better at Googling. And no, I'm just kidding. We do get better at our skills too. But it's very true that no one knows everything, and even the most senior of senior people have more senior people that they ask for help from. It's not though you get to this point where you stop asking for help. And I think the bigger red flag is if you get to a point where you stop asking for help, it might mean you're stuck, or it might mean that your growth has stopped. And that's another issue on its own. Another thing that I've learned, but I'm still really working on, is to avoid the negative self-talk. This is something that I still face, and going back to the start of this video, I was totally candid with you and told you I was crying, because sometimes you can get into a rut where you feel like you can't solve it, you keep on questioning your skills, and it just goes downhill really quickly with your mindset. It's so important to catch that early on and recognize, hey, this is negative self-talk, this is not okay, and kind of flip the script. Why are you feeling this way? What is going on? Reaching out to people who you believe can support you and you trust and can be vulnerable with. And that sometimes is hard to find, but when you do find someone who can really support you, even when you are feeling this way, it's just makes a world of a difference. And it also goes, I think I've learned this more through putting content out than I have through coding, because every time, if I am really honest, every time I am feeling this way and I put a piece of content out saying, hey, today sucked, I feel like a crappy coder, I get so many messages of people being like, me too, I feel that way too sometimes. And it just really makes me realize, wow, everyone has those days. Everyone feels that way, and it's okay. We just need to not let those thoughts consume us. Another thing that I definitely did backwards in my career was you should focus on core concepts rather than just learning frameworks or more programming languages. This, when I was starting out in my career, I was so focused on learning more programming languages, more frameworks, more libraries, that I skipped a lot of the core concepts. And that really affected me, I would say, midway through my career, early on in my career, because I didn't have a solid base, a solid foundation for the core concepts. Learn the core concepts. It doesn't matter if you're learning them in Python, JavaScript, whatever. Learn them. Yes, it might be tempting to switch over because you see that now Python's the hottest language, or whatever is coming down the pipeline is the hottest language of 2022. The reality is, once you master the fundamentals of one language, it's so much easier to pick up another language. Those are some of the things that I really have learned in my past 5 years. Oh, I'm sighing because I know I have so far to go still, and I think that's a good thing. I think that's a good thing. That is a good thing. It's a great thing, actually. It means there's so much to learn, and it's just getting in the mindset that you're a forever learner, and that's a positive. And to really flip the script of trying to catch up with everyone to know everything and realizing, no, I'm never going to know everything, but just being open to things as they come your way and making sure that when you are learning something, you're learning the core fundamentals. Okay, I felt like I just had a therapy session for myself. I just need to sit down and share some of my learnings with you. And I hope you found this valuable and helpful as well, just hearing some of my top learnings as a software developer. It's one of those things that you are a forever learner and you just keep on going. But I'm curious to know, what are some of the things for those of you who are already software developers or in the tech industry in general that you have learned in your time spent in the industry? Leave in the comments below. Thanks, everyone. We'll be right back.